geology professor Kelsey Feser and John Lewis are sorting through dozens of containers filled with shells. These samples are key to their Cornell Summer Research Institute project, especially a certain kind of shell.
A chione.
Professor Feser collected these from seagrass beds located around St. Croix Island, one of the U.S. Virgin Islands. She says when organisms die, their shells sink to the seafloor and accumulate over time.
So beneath seagrass beds, there's a potential to preserve what we call original stratigraphy, which means that nice layer cake that you kind of picture that geologists love, because then you know that the oldest stuff is on the bottom and the youngest stuff is on the top.
Their goal is to find out the age of these shells. The information can then help them answer bigger questions about changes over time.
So the issue is trying to get a decent enough resolution to be able to narrow down when human activities could have had effects on these changes. Because otherwise, any interpretations you try to make are fairly meaningless.
When we're sampling, we usually sample down to about a depth of 40 centimeters below the seafloor, basically. But the problem is we don't know whether that 40 centimeters represents 100 years, 1,000 years, 10,000 years. So without that understanding, we can't really say anything about how the shells, the dead shells that were once living in that environment, we can't say too much about how they've been affected, especially by human impact.
As part of their summer research, they're going to date the shells using a process called amino acid racemization at Cornell University in New York, where there's a special lab.
We can get ages now as specific as, maybe on the order of like within 10 years of when it actually died. So resolution is really, really good.
They will continue to examine these shells throughout the summer and have high hopes for the aging outcomes of their 10-week research project.
The current hope to get a grip on primarily the maximum age of these samples so that I know what we're really working with on how far back this time averaging goes.
This particular project is actually kind of pivotal for a bunch of other projects that I have in mind for the next, 5 or 10 years. So it's really kickstarting this project in a big way, and that probably wouldn't be happening if it weren't for the summer research program. So I've been really fortunate and very fortunate to have a student like John working with me.
This is just one story detailing all of the summer research projects going on at Cornell College. Watch for others in the Cornell College News Center or follow us on Facebook for more information.